The World This Week, Business.
Hello guys, what up? And welcome to my channel again. So this is Bruce from Bruce's English. So let's talk about business for this week and let's get started.
China became the world's biggest exporter of vehicles in 2023, according to the China Passenger Car Association. The association thinks that China exported nearly 5.3 million vehicles last year, accelerating it past Japan, which is thought to have sold 4.3 million vehicles abroad. Petrol-powered vehicles accounted for the bulk of the exports, notably to Russia. But electric vehicles are taking a growing share of China's overseas market. The CPCA reckons that 6.1 million full electric vehicles were sold in China last year, up by 22% from 2022.
China became the world's biggest exporter of vehicles in 2023. 中国变成了世界上最大的 exporter, 是出口者,出口国, vehicles 是车辆, in 2023. According to the China Passenger Car Association, 是中国的乘用车协会啊 ,passenger 就是啊乘客乘用的 ,ok. The association thinks that China exported nearly 5.3 million vehicles last year. 啊这个协会的话呢认为啊中国出口了接近呢是530万辆车啊的去年。Accelerating it past Japan. 啊 ,accelerate 是表示呢加速是吧啊加速增长超过了 ,pass 超过了日本。Which is thought to have sold 4.3 million vehicles abroad. OK, which 引导的定语从句呢修饰日本日本呢被认为呢是出口了430万辆车就是在去年。Petrol powered vehicles accounted for the bulk of the exports. OK, 那么我们说汽油车或者是那个油车 ,petrol 是石油。当然了我们说如果说加汽油的话呢在美国是 gas, GES, 在英国的话呢是 petrol, 是吧是那个油车accounted for 指的是占比是 bulk of the exports 是出口那么这个 bulk 指的是就是占比最大的部分就 bulk, OK, 油车的出口的话呢是占出口量最大的一个部分。Okay, 主要是出口到俄罗斯说的是中国是吧 But electric vehicles are taking a growing share of China's overseas market. Okay, 但是呢我们说电动汽车electric 是电车就电动电的用烧电的是吧用电的。我们要和这个 electronic 区分开来我们说电子产品是 electronic products. Okay, 那么电的话呢是 electric, electric, okay.电车的话呢是增长的话呢growing share, 就是它的占比呢增长越来越大增长占比越来越大是中国的海外的市场就是海外的这个出口车辆的市场。The CPCA, 中国乘用车协会reckons that, 认为呢 ,6 million full electric vehicles, full 是那个就是完全的是吧完全的电动汽车were sold in China last year, okay? 就是纯电动车在中国呢去年呢卖了610万辆 up by 22% from 2022, okay? 从2022和这个2022年相比的话呢它增长了 22%, okay? 纯电动的叫 full electric, 当然除了petrol powered, 就是油车还有 full electric, there's another type, 还有另外一种呢我们知道叫Hybrid 叫混合动力的是吧那么其实它还有细分就是分那个插电的有这个 plug 的是吧还有那个non-plug type 就是不用插电的嘛就是那种传统的混动吧或者是不用插电的混动是吧这个细分的挺多的哈 OK 好 Let's move on to the next part
As Chinese car makers move into top gear, Volkswagen finds itself falling behind in China, which was once a source of ambitious growth for the German company. VW sales in China rose by just 1.6% in 2023. The overall domestic market grew by 5.6%, though the country still accounts for a third of its global market. VW is also struggling to keep up with demand for EVs. It delivered 394,000 fully electric vehicles worldwide in 2023, far behind the 1.6 million that were sold by BYD, China's biggest electric car maker.
首先我们看一下这个标题叫 Backseat Driver。Backseat Driver 指的是指手画脚的人啊。这个是一个俚语的说法，就是坐在车的后座位呢，他提出一些呢没有必要的 unwanted, unnecessary advices, 叫指手画脚的人。OK, 那么这个地方做标题的话呢，我觉得更应该是另外一个意思，就是落后了是吧，就是说那个德国的车的销量呢已经或者是德国车在中国的销量呢已经落后了，或者是那个增长已经减慢了啊，叫 backseat driver。好了，我们看一下 ，as Chinese car makers move into top gear， gear 呢是档位啊，就是随着中国的汽车制造商呢，进入到了最高的档位啊，就是加速前进到最高档是吧 ？Volkswagen 啊，我们知道德国的大众汽车是吧 ？Find itself falling behind in China。发现呢自己呢 fall behind 是落后了在中国 ，which was once a source of ambitious growth for the German company 啊，那么大众汽车的话呢，在中国是过去的话呢是一个source 是来源啊，是一个有野心的增长啊，野心勃勃的增长是吧？对于这个德国公司来说啊，中国的大众的话呢，对于整个的大众公司是非常重要的啊。Volkswagen sales in China rose by just 1.6% in 2023，大众汽车的销量的话呢，在中国只增长了1.6%啊，在2023年，the overall domestic market grew by 5.6%， 就是整个的国内市场，中国的国内市场呢，增长率是5.6%。Though the country still accounts for a third of its global market， 尽管如此呢，这个国家呢仍然呢是占整个市场的这个。比例的话呢占比是1/3啊 ,OK。这个国家指的是中国呢占它就是德国的这个大众公司的话呢是整个的全球市场的1/3啊 ,OK。Volkswagen is also struggling to keep up with demand for EVs。Volkswagen 的话呢也在挣扎呢去叫 keep up, 是跟上这个电动车 EV 是电车的这个需求 demand 是吧 ？Okay, it delivered 394,000 fully electric vehicles worldwide in 2023. 那么大众车这个公司的话呢，他们提供了供应了394,000辆纯电动车在2023年在全球的市场 far behind 是吧？远远落后呢 the 1.6 million 160万辆车是吧 ？That were sold by BYD。就是比亚迪卖的160万辆车 ，China's biggest electric car maker， 中国最大的电动车制造商BYD， OK， 那么这个呢，其实也大众公司的话呢，也要小心了 ，gotta be careful。我们知道，在 Apple iPhone 出来之前的话呢，最大的the biggest phone maker supplier was actually Nokia from Finland。当时的诺基亚呢，是芬兰的，是全球占比最大的啊，苹果出来没有几年的话呢，诺基亚就风光不再啊。那么现在诺基亚在什么地方？还在卖一些老年机啊，也卖一两款的，可能是贴牌的机器吧，是吧？所以说呢，这个尽管呢 ，Volkswagen 的话呢是傲视群雄的，是吧？那么现在的话呢，也要小心了。OK， 好 ，Let's move on。
Boeing's chief executive, Dave Calhoun, promised that the aerospace company would be completely transparent in helping an investigation into an incident in which a panel came off a 737 MAX 9 passenger jet that had just taken off from Portland. Nobody was injured on the Alaska Airlines flight, which returned to the airport with a gaping hole in its side. The Federal Aviation Administration grounded some 737 MAX 9s while inspections were carried out.The investigation's initial focus is on the bolts that secured the panel, which fell into a teacher's garden in Portland.
有一个笑话呢，是在飞机上，如果你感觉到比较闷热啊，在飞行的时候啊 ，during the flight, could you ask the air hostess to open the windows or not? Okay, 可不可以问空乘人员 the attendants, right? Okay, flight attendants 或者是 air hostess，OK，、okay? 能不能打开这个窗户啊？结论是可以，我们就看一下这条新闻是吧？Boeing's chief executive，波音的这个首席执行官哈是 Dave Calhoun，OK，、okay? Dave 这个人 promised that 他承诺的话呢，the aerospace company 这家这个波音的这家公司嘛，飞机制造商是吧？Would be completely transparent。Transparent 是透明的，会完全透明，是吧？In helping an investigation 来帮助一个调查，into an incident 调查一个事件啊，in which a panel 啊came off a 373啊 a 737 Max 9 passenger jet that had just taken off from Portland 啊，什么样的一个事件呢？就是一个面板啊，panel 是飞机的一块面板啊，就是。我看过那个视频，好像就在窗户的位置，是吧？came off 是掉下来了，是吧？是一架呢737的这个 MAX 9的一个机型的一个客机 passenger jet 是吧？客机 that had just taken off from Portland 从波特兰呢刚刚起飞啊，那个美国的 Portland。Nobody was injured on the Alaska Airlines flight 没有人受伤呢，在这个阿拉斯加的这个航线的这个飞机上是一个非常。不幸中的万幸啊，which returned to the airport with a gaping hole in its side，回到了这个机场啊，它有一个 gaping hole in its side。好，我们看一下 gape 啊，gape 是裂开啊，打呵欠或张嘴的意思，有一个啊回到了机场的话呢，就是有一个大的裂口呢在边上。The Federal Aviation Administration 啊，美国的这个 FAA 啊，是美国联邦航空管理局，grounded some seven three seven MAX nines, while inspections were carried out. OK，美国的联邦航空管理局的话呢，grounded 就是禁飞了啊，禁止飞行了一些这个737的大飞机是吧？就是当这个调查正在进行的时候啊，were carried out 被这在过去呢进行的时候，the investigation's initial focus is on the boats. 调查的最初的这个关注点的话呢是 the boats. Boats 是螺栓啊，是这个。是这个螺栓是吧？That secured the panel 是固定这个面板的这个螺栓，secure 是固定啊。Which fell into a teacher's garden in Portland，它掉到了一个老师的一家的一一那个一个老师家里的花园里边啊，在这个波特兰。OK，好，Let's move on。
OpenAI responded in detail to a lawsuit lodged by the New York Times that claims the startup used the newspaper's content to create and train its chatbot, ChatGPT. In a blog post, OpenAI said the lawsuit was without merit and that the Times was not telling the full story. Meanwhile, the European Union announced an initial probe into whether Microsoft's huge investment in OpenAI falls foul of its law on mergers.Britain's antitrust regulator opened a similar review in December.
好，我们知道 OpenAI 呢，它回应了就是非常详细的回应了 in detail 是吧？To a lawsuit lodged by the New York Times，回应一个法就是诉讼lawsuit，lodged by the New York Times，lodge 我们知道是小屋啊，或者是动词的话呢是提出的意思，是由《纽约时报》提出的，that claims the startup。他们声明呢，《纽约时报》呢提告或声称呢，这家创业公司 OpenAI 这家公司 used the newspaper's content 使用了报纸的一些内容呢，去创造啊，to create and train its chatbot，创造呢还有这个训练它的聊天机器人啊，ChatGPT。In a blog post，OpenAI said，在一个博客的一个发文呢，OpenAI 呢声明是吧？这个 lawsuit 这个提告。这个诉讼案件的话呢，was without merit 没有好处，and that the Times was not telling the full story，纽约时报的话呢，并没有把整个的故事都说出来，就是它的信息呢没有提供完整的信息啊。Meanwhile, the European Union announced an initial probe into whether Microsoft's huge investment on OpenAI falls foul on its law on mergers。好，同时的话呢，这个欧盟嘛。他宣布了一个最初的一个调查，probe 是调查，是吧？Microsoft 微软的这个巨大的这个投资，是吧？在 OpenAI 里边是有没有违反 false foul 是吧？就是违反呢，它的就是这种叫做 反那个垄断的法律 merger 我们叫合并反垄断的法律是吧 OK Britain's antitrust 反垄断的这个 regulator 这个监管部门 opened a similar review in December 在12月份呢也提出了一个同样的一个观点啊 OK 这个 Microsoft invested a lot of money in OpenAI 投资了 OpenAI 很多钱然后在某个时间段嘛它已经超过了这个 Apple 成为世界上市值最大的公司啊那么我不知道他们现在的股价是多少那么之前苹果的话呢是超过了4万亿美金吧它的市值那么微软的话呢是超过了它啊在某一个时间点 OK That's pretty amazing, you know?
America's Securities and Exchange Commission approved applications from some of the world's biggest financial companies such as BlackRock to start offering exchange-traded funds tied to Bitcoin for the first time, a huge boost for advocates of cryptocurrencies. The day before the announcement, the X account of the SEC was hacked by an attacker who posted a fake announcement that the regulator had already approved the ETFs,causing Bitcoin's price to rise briefly by more than $1,000.
America's Securities and Exchange Commission approved applications from some of the world's biggest financial companies. 美国的证券交易委员会啊，通过了世界上最大的一些金融公司的一些这种申请是吧 ？OK， 比如说这个叫 BlackRock 黑岩 to start offering exchange traded funds.ETF 啊，就是在另外一个报道里边呢，一个节目里边呢，我也详细解释了什么是 ETF 啊，就是ETF 基金 ，OK， 就是美国证券交易委员会呢批准了美国很大几家非常大的券商嘛，他们对于比特币这种 ETF 基金的这个申请是吧 ？OK， tied to Bitcoin for the first time， 第一次呢通过了这个比特币的 ETF 的这个申请 ，a huge boost for advocates of cryptocurrencies。Cryptocurrency 指的是加密货币啊，那是一个巨大的一个 boost 啊，提升对于这个加密货币的支持者来说。The day before the announcement, the X account of the SEC was hacked by an attacker who posted a fake announcement that the regulator had already approved the ETFs. Okay, 啊，这是一个有意思的事件嘛，在这个宣布之前啊，美国证券委员会的这个他的 X 他的账户啊，一个社交媒体的账户。是被黑了是被 hacked 被黑了是吧被一个黑客 attacker 那么这个黑客的话呢这是一个定语从句呢修饰这个黑客是吧他发出了一个假的一个声明啊就是这个监管机构的话呢在过去呢已经通过了 ETF 哦后面呢是一个状语啊引发了这个比特币的价格的话呢短时间呢上升呢超过了 $1,000 OK So thanks guys, thanks for your time and really appreciate it. So see you guys next time. Bye bye.